sexy for my shoes. Too sexy for my shoes. Shoes going to leave me.
This week on I'm Too Sexy for My Shoes, we focus on something that promises to uplift any woman's mood instantly. We are talking about jewelry. So let's go back in time and find out, when did the sense of personal adornment first occur to mankind?
Hundred thousand years old beads made from the sardius shells in Israel and Algeria are thought to be the oldest known jewelry to mankind. The legacy of jewelry in India spans over 5,000 years. India was the first country to mine diamonds, with some mines dating back to 296 BC. However, despite India's rich heritage, in the early 20th century, Indian princes were receptive to the work of European jewelers and eagerly asked them to reset their stones in the latest Western styles. For instance, in 1905, Boucheron made a turban ornament with platinum set with diamonds for the Maharaja of Kapurthala. In 1928, Cartier made a necklace with rubies, diamonds and pearls set in platinum for the Maharaja of Patiala. And in 1948, Van Cleef & Arpels designed a necklace with diamonds and emeralds for the Maharani Sita Devi of Baroda. Precedent set by royalty itself. In the decades ahead, these brands became household names for those looking for quality, bespoke design and an international stamp. We dwell in the history of one such brand.
A unique feature of this Cartier boutique is that on the second floor, you have the workshop for the high jewelry. We lay the red carpet and get you exclusive access to the workshop where work is in progress for the brand's current collection, christened Secrets and Wonders.
The USP of Cartier's jewels is that they have a contemporary story with a tradition of quality. Here it takes years to get the right look. And yes, first the stones are sourced and then the designs are created.
So once we have the stones in our hands, we do consider that we need 2 years really for the collection to be ready. A few months to design all the pieces, and then not less than 1 year, 1 year and a half to actually make them.
Each of the workers in this workshop boasts of true experience.
We do consider that even if the workers come from a specific school, they need at least 10 years to be allowed to work alone on one piece, because we do think that 10 years are really the necessary period to acquire the skills to really work on the way Cartier wants it, to work on the pieces we offer to our customers.
The high jewelry collection has unique designs. The execution of some needs close to 1,000 hours of artisanal work. The 70-piece collection has four broad names: the Snake Queen collection, the Peacock Queen collection, the Pearl collection and the Diamond collection.
Peacocks and snakes are traditional themes in the Cartier world.
The most exceptional part of the workshop is the last step, the polishing process that happens with this thread. After months of labor, Cartier's current high jewelry collection is ready, and you are about to view some of the final pieces of it in a few moments. We begin with the Snake Queen collection.
Tubar.com.